Welcome to our course on QuickBooks for Attorneys. This course will give attorneys everything they need to know to manage the books and records of their law firm using QuickBooks. This particular video is an overview of what attorneys need, and it will help you set up the file so that you can manage your books and records using QuickBooks. Attorneys should use most of QuickBooks the way every other business does. However, lawyers have unique challenges that these videos will address. You may well ask, what does an attorney need to do in QuickBooks that other, more common companies don't need to do? Well, attorneys are required to record retainer payments when they get paid in advance, and they have to make sure when they get paid in advance, they record it as unearned income. Attorneys make the unearned income become earned income as time goes by or as services are given. Attorneys have to keep track of every client's balance and how much is prepaid and how much is owed to or from each client. Attorneys have to give a retainer receipt when receiving payment in advance of a service given. Attorneys have to keep track of specific expenses and allocate them and track them for each individual client. And these are the legal requirements that law firms have when managing their books and records. What does your practice file have? Well, included in this course is a practice file that has a client list, a sample client list, so you can imagine what it's like to manage your clients, a vendor list. These are companies whom we pay for the services that we need. A basic chart of accounts. Preferences set in the preferences window. An icon bar of shortcuts to the only things that we will need. This icon bar is customized for our needs, and everything in the icon bar is what attorneys need, and attorneys probably don't need anything that's not already up and saved in the icon bar. Customize reports that suit our needs as the attorney's bookkeeper. So the reports that are in the icon bar are the only ones that attorneys need. All the other reports you can disregard and save yourself some time. Now, if you don't know any of these six things or you don't know how to create a company file, please watch our videos about these topics. And I have included basic introductory QuickBooks topics as part of this course, and I call them supplemental videos, and they're listed after the main videos. So the first few videos you see will be things that are specific to attorneys. And then once you finish watching those, if there's any knowledge you feel you need to have, you can go back and watch the introductory videos, and they will give you the knowledge of these six items plus more, and then you'll be prepared to watch the attorney videos again. So what specific steps do attorneys need to do in QuickBooks to set up their file? Well, first, they need an account in the chart of accounts called unearned retainer fees. And whenever they get a deposit from a client, this will be the account that records the money amount until the money is earned. The type of account for unearned retainer fees is an accounts receivable type of account. That's because it does not matter what type of account it is. It matters how the account shows up on the financial statements. We have to put an item on the items list called fees earned and connect it to the income from fees earned account. And I will walk you through this step by step. If you need to track your income, you could have several income accounts and several matching items for those accounts. When I say track your income, I mean have more than one income account in your chart of accounts, have a different income account in your chart of accounts for each of the different services your law firm provides. If you did that, you would be able to tell the difference between how much money you made from one service compared to how much money you made from another. But that's not something that you will get from this video series. That's something you can easily get from one of the supplemental introductory videos. So in the series of attorney videos, we will only have one income account, and that is what we will use for our example. And the last setup step that's specific for attorneys, we have to make a retainer receipt. That's a document template that's made from a customer credit memo. And that's the document that we have to give to the client when the client pays us in advance for future attorney services. So let's take a look at the file and see what's already there. The icon bar in this file is set up with a shortcut to every window that we will need to use during this course. Of course, in a real situation, a law firm might have to use the main menu to open up one or two additional windows, but we will save time by putting the shortcuts to the windows that we need right here. This way, you don't have to memorize all these different main menu choices. You can learn that after you finish the course. You should take a look at how things are set up now. From the main menu, click List Chart of Accounts. And of course, if you know a little bit about accounting or you watch the supplemental videos, you know what the chart of accounts is. I have included this sample chart of accounts for the Ross Scheister Law Firm, which is our example company, and it's the file that you're in. Notice it has most of the accounts that you already need. The only difference is I excluded the specific accounts that a law firm would need, and therefore we can put them on the list now. Let's add unearned retainer fee to the accounts in the chart of accounts. Remember, it's an accounts receivable type of account. So, once the chart of accounts is open, we click Account, New, and we go down here and we click Accounts Receivable. That's because unearned retainer fees is an accounts receivable type of account. Click Continue, and you see accounts receivable is in the account type pull down. Click the account name, and what do they want us? Unearned retainer fees. So we're going to type in, it's better if it's capital, unearned retainer fees. And then we click Save and Close. Good. Now unearned retainer fees are in the accounts in the chart of accounts. What else do we have to do to set up the file? Let's add our one income item to the items list. It's called fees earned. And after we put it on the items list, we're going to link it to the income from fees earned account in the chart of accounts. From the main menu, click List, Item List. Then from the bottom left, click Item, New. We agree it's a service, so we click Service. The item name will be Fees Earned. Let's put it in capital. It looks nicer. Fees Earned. Now, let's connect it to the account Income from Legal Fees, which is Income. Now we click OK, and now we can see we have the item that we're going to place on an invoice every time we earn fees by doing a service for the client. And now, the last setup step that's specific for attorneys. Let's make a retainer receipt document template from a credit memo. This way, we can give our clients a document as proof that they paid us in advance for our legal service. From the main menu, click Customers, Create Credit Memo. The credit memo has a ribbon that can be opened and collapsed, and the ribbon has three tabs. Click the Formatting tab, and directly under the word Formatting, click Manage Templates. Then, in the Manage Templates window, go to the bottom and click OK. After the basic customization window opens up, click on the bottom left, Additional Customization. Now here's where we decide what columns and what titles and what headings will be on the client retainer receipt. First, let's remove some of the things we don't need, like purchase order and something like project. And the only major change we need to make is click where it says default title and change the words credit memo to retainer receipt. Actually, you should make it lowercase so that it will fit on the document. Retainer receipt. Or you could call it client retainer receipt. Then when we click OK, and then click OK again, and then click OK again, and then click OK again, you see the document no longer says credit memo, it says retainer receipt. And we can print this and give this to the client when the client pays in advance. Congratulations, your file is now set up specifically for a law firm.